All right, everyone. So a few months ago, I made a video about ChatDash, which for those of you that are unaware, is an analytics dashboard that allows your clients to get a white labeled version of a dashboard where they can view transcripts and some analytics charts and the knowledge base that your VoiceFlow assistants are tied into. And I thought this was a great solution at the time, because I had, you know, some clients that were specifically requesting some of these features, and VoiceFlow did not offer these solutions out of the box. So I had no problem making a video about ChatDash and talking to people about it, because I thought it was a great solution. They were doing a good job, which is click a few buttons, tie this into your existing VoiceFlow projects, and move on. Now, on that same sentence, while I have no problem making videos and promoting a bunch of traffic towards ChatDash when they do good things, I also have to call them out when they do the opposite. And that's what this video is about today. And a kind of a growing concern I have in the back of my mind about this ecosystem that is kind of building on top of VoiceFlow. So what's going on with ChatDash? So I got an email from a client last week and they said, Connor, why are all the transcripts stopped after May the 4th? And I'm like, what do you mean the transcripts have stopped? And sure enough, there are no transcripts that have been recorded in my client's account since May 4th. So I said, huh, it's kind of weird. What's going on? Let me go to ChatDash's Discord. Oh, we got a major update. Oh, great announcement. Hey, ChatDash, new chatbots, unified conversions, yeah, bot press support. This is normal roadmap feature speak for any SaaS application. Okay. Let me scroll down. 2 days later, some clarification on the new update. Using the ChatDash chat widget. With the new update, we collect conversation data through ChatDash chat widget. Both the conversations and analytics page that you see rely on this data. Therefore, you will need to use the ChatDash chat widget instead of what the chatbot platforms provide. So, in other words, every single person that was paying ChatDash monthly for their product, every single live AI assistant that was on the street stopped working across the board. They just pushed an update. They didn't get any customer feedback to say, hey, you know, is this going to impact you guys, or we've got some new features, we want to head in this direction, but in order to do this, we need our own widget. Is that something you guys would still be cool with? They just pushed it live. I just sent it. And what happened was every single person that was using ChatDash, it just broke. Now they said, oh, for users who had projects set up before the update, don't worry. We migrated over your transcripts and threads previously, so you can still see those conversations. However, going forward, newly created projects solely rely on the data collected from the ChatDash widget. But what about the time period between people became aware of this new chat widget and the time they installed it on a live site? If you even have access to the live site anymore, depending on your products that you've been building for your clients, they're not there. They're not available, right? So what a crazy, crazy misstep by ChatDash in general on the first part, big whiff, because their main value proposition to all of their clients was, let me click a few buttons, tie into VoiceFlow, and then get out of my way, right? Because now with this new update, I've got this ChatDash chat widget that I have to come. Is this compatible with some of the VoiceFlow functionality that I have running into the script? And spoiler alert, it's not, right? So now I have to figure out what this script tag does. I've got to adjust the branding. Oh, powered by ChatDash. You think that's what was going to go customer facing for all of this? Like ChatDash is the main value here in these chatbots. So I got to delete it, you know, and save. Oh, wait, when you do that, it doesn't work. I actually have to delete it and then put like a period here. Oh, okay. Thank you for the ChatDash logo in this. That's definitely what my customers are going to say. Okay, let me upload a project image. Okay, great. What happens when we push this to a site? Let me pull over. We're going to get a little Figma action. Look at this widget. This is the widget. I drew these lines in Figma, by the way, because I wanted to show you this centered. What is this? It's off-centered. It's not even centered within the bubble. This looks like my grandma coded this. And can I adjust this launcher widget? Where's that? Where's that in this theme and the settings and all this great customization that you've given us? The answer is it's not there. And the answer is nobody wanted this. Nobody was asking for this because nobody wants to install ChatDash script tags onto their website. They want to install VoiceFlow script tags on their website. They're the main company. You are the side project here. And unfortunately, ChatDash has got it in its head that they think that they can provide more value to the marketplace by doing this. And I think it's a huge mistake, and it's a huge middle finger to everybody that has paid ChatDash and deployed agents live to just have the product taken away from them with one push. So those are my thoughts in general. But I think this brings up a few other points, and not to just start picking on all of these third-party applications that are built on top of VoiceFlow, because let's be honest, a lot of times they are building out really helpful solutions and putting in a lot of dev work, and I appreciate their efforts, and I appreciate them indie hacking this and trying to make money and all of this stuff, but they have to remember their place. Here's VoiceGlow update that just happened this last week. Quick update. Please note, we'll be updating how the pricing for web widgets in the coming days work for user visits since we've seen a scary surge in our cloud storage credit. Right now, visits to your website do not consume any credits if you disable the auto start option. In the coming days, we'll be rolling out an update where every user visit will cost 0.2 credits, regardless if the user interacted with your widget or not, if VoiceGlow hosts a widget, code, and images. So basically, the way that VoiceGlow worked is they only charged you a load token if somebody interacted with the chat widget and it loaded. Now it doesn't even matter. Anytime that the website page renders on the front end, you're going to be charged, and this is a fractional token. But regardless, this is going to amplify the cost of VoiceGlow by a very large multiple. Now, thankfully, Mo is a solid developer, and VoiceGlow is a much more polished product than some of the other things out there. And I've used VoiceGlow for certain builds for certain functionalities because some of their blocks are very useful. Okay. Heads up, you can still avoid this charge by hosting the scripts and images on your own server. As a bonus, that will also achieve white labeling. However, the downside of hosting your own widget code, it's no longer tied into VoiceGlow update. So what do you have? Now you have to start tracking all of the stuff, and you have to start doing all of this extra stuff. And the base value of using these third-party applications, it starts to become less and less appealing because it's more things that you have to track, and it's more things that are interrupting your workflow. Remember, these third-party solutions and ties and integrations are supposed to be snappy, in and out, and let me keep building, let me keep going. And all of this stuff is starting to pile up because they're starting to make some money, right? And it's a natural progression, which is, how do I make more money? Well, I need more features. Well, how do I build more features? Well, I'm starting to become limited because I have to ping this VoiceFlow script and their APIs and what they allow me. I know, I'm gonna be the driver now. I'm the captain now, okay? But there's a huge trade-off when you start doing this. Now, we could also say, maybe it's time to start thinking about developing your solutions yourself. Okay, Connor, why are you complaining so much? You don't have to use these products. You don't have to use VoiceGlow. You don't have to use ChatDash. And you're absolutely right. And that's probably the direction that I'm going to start heading, because there is a cost here, especially as your agency scales, as you start getting more chatbots online. Think about if I had 50 chatbots running through ChatDash, and I had to go in and I had to modify 50 different things across the board. It would be an all-stop for me. And it would interrupt me working on my current workflows and handling my new client caseload, having to go back and handle all of this technical debt that I've accumulated. And that's what you'll notice as you start working with more and more clients and get more of them on a monthly retainer. This is technical debt that you're accumulating, where you have to make sure that your solutions that you build out are going to continue to work the way that they're supposed to work. So keep that in mind, that it's great to see, I don't know, who's doing this dashboard? Who's got this functionality? Who's got this integration? Click, 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 sign up, sign up, sign up, sign up. Tread carefully is all that I'm saying. It's unfortunate to see the direction that this is heading, because I want to support these guys. I want to support the builds, but not if they're going to start doing this. But anyways, love to know your guys' thoughts. That's all I got for today. Happy building out there.